Good day! I'm back, and it's time to finish up Old Yharnam. I'm gonna go whip up on the bloodstarved beast. She has some really weird eyeballs. I've noticed that. I don't know if that's what the artists used with texturing work or what before they decided on getting one right and just sort of left what they had before. Let's get this full screen. Yeah, I noticed that was really weird. Alright, here we go. And we've got our shortcut right there. Hey guy. Forgot how slow it is when it's opened up like that. Ooh, tempering blades. Which one is that? I don't think I can use that one with this weapon. Think that that's one that can fit in this cleaver. Did he hear me? It's cheap. Anyways, there is a red-eyed werewolf. And he can be super nasty. So again, if you're not familiar with how they move, he doesn't move really any different from the regular ones, but if you're not familiar with how the werewolves move and kind of lunge at you, he can be really, really nasty. Oh, there he is. Down here there's some really tall grass with more of those guys in capes. As well as Alfred Summon Son right there, but I'm gonna take these guys off first. They're easy to miss, and I'm sure I'll miss one of them because it's been so long since I've done this, but if you get a certain distance away from them, or past them, then they'll actually get up and kind of sneak up on you. Bloodstarved beast is all the way in there. Just kind of waiting, and a little disappointing that you don't get a really cool cinematic opening, opening boss fight cinematic with this guy, because he's a really well animated boss. Like, I mean, pretty much all of them. But he's particularly nasty with all the skin and slobber and whatnot. So anyways, we're gonna summon old Alfredo here. And I'm gonna get antidotes because of the poison. In case I get poisoned. And some Molotovs. I got fire paper too, don't I? This stuff is pretty rare and expensive at this point in the game. So I'm gonna try not to waste it. just for good measure.
Get him.
So he can be... he can be a really tough boss this early in the game. The poisoning is, as you saw, just completely is relentless. And because you have to get so close to him to hit him, the risk of getting poisoned is pretty high. So having those antidotes is right there, pretty handy. Anyways, we are done with the old Yharnam. And now it's up to the old workshop area, which is where you find the item that lets you the shining badge. It's the one that lets you get Ludwig's blade.
Welcome home. I must. What is it? Very well.
Let's
let me.
What we want to get here. If I usually get 1 or 2 points of stamina per level or not.
Yeah. Farewell, good.
If I can use that tempering gem. Okay. Yeah, and that doesn't even show up. Looks like it'll unlock with the third one once I get this thing up to +5.
The healing church. Well, once they worked today, but they have so have said.
Okay, so he's telling me to go up there now too. I need to grab the co-op bell. And also need... well, I kind of want to get Gascoigne set just in case I get captured by one of the Sack Bros and taken to a Yharghul. Because there's that woman down there that you can rescue and send to the chapel as long as you're wearing either Gascoigne set or the other church, white church, black church robe, which you can find on the streets of, you can find on the Yharnam streets in the Cathedral Ward, I believe. Anyways. Okay. The door's open now, though it was closed before. I think this is our first rune. Yeah. So, yeah, whoop-de-doo, one extra blood vial. I guess if that one vial is the difference between life and death, then it's a big deal. Okay, so this obviously is not what it seems in terms of simplicity. We've got him, and you've got him, and then you've got this guy that's going to run at you. And if you try to run in there thinking that you're going to be safe, there's several more guys that you have to fight. So realistically, the only way you can go is like that way and sort of wait for this guy to come in there and then kind of dance around these fools in this room. So there we go. This is the way to go, but before we go down there, we have to go up to get the badge. There's one guy, there's another guy, and then there's a shield guy right there. You can see a bunch of hunter weapons, so you kind of can see how this is starting to draw some parallels with what you see in the dream workshop. But run head first in this situation. There is a guy you have to watch out for right there, and then there's a wheelchair guy that'll be opening fire at you. So let's do this. Slow. Can I hear some big footsteps? And oh. Oh. Big footsteps belong to him. I think it's down one floor where the item is. Sky and the cosmos are one. Again, the trick to these guys is just to sprint behind them and kind of move in a circle. And this is where we eventually will find our way into the choir area. But it's locked. Which I'm almost positive is an optional area. You have to go there if you want to fight. I think you have to go there if you want to fight a Breedus. Which, in my opinion, has the best music of any fight in this game. Just this whole game soundtrack is phenomenal. What? Oh, he must have come up from falling down. Time to fall down here, and there's one of those little nightmare guys, that crystal lizards. Or is there? Where'd you go? If I scared him off. Okay. So you have two different routes you can go here. Obviously you can go down there and then just way, way further down to the very bottom. Or you can fall. You can roll off straight ahead towards these ropes, and you'll land on the platform down there, kind of where the tips of the ropes are. So that's what we're gonna do first. Alright. And this is the actual workshop, I believe. So this is the one that the one in the dream is based off of. Doll swag. There's some interesting things in here. Got a small hair ornament that you can give to the doll in the dream. Kind of opens up some new dialogue for her. And no weapons or anything in this one. There's really no signs of it being a hunter's workshop. and a very important item for endgame. Gotta get three of them. And there's two of them, or four of them in the game. And one thing that Epic Name Bro managed to, I don't know if he was the first one to find it or he pointed it out. You can watch her fingers. And they're twitching. Which, I don't know what that means, but it's kind of weird and interesting. She is killing it on the mannequin challenge, I'll tell you that. So, let's see. The old hunter's bone. Okay, so that's about all you can do here. We're gonna zip back to the game.
What is it? What? What is this? I can't remember. Not a thing, only I feel a yearning, something I never felt before. What's happening to me? Tell me, Hunter, could this be joy? Welcome home. What is it you? Very well, let me.
I bet it's not enough. Oh! Close. Okay, let's see if this one. Okay, so that gives me a 2 as well. That she gave us is kind of like the brooch, I believe. You can see. 45 is a weapon. So let's see what this one does. So long, I can't remember. Oh, HP continues. I don't think that was a very good one. I don't remember it being. I don't remember using it at all, at least. So I'm gonna whip back. Essentially go back to that big giant pit. I think I scared away that little nightmare creature, whatever it is, that drops the shards, because I remember him being there the first time.
Then.
could have sworn there was one of those guys here. Anyways, okay. Try not to get myself killed doing this, because there's a couple of really big drops on this. No feline ring swag to let me survive either. Try to get items. No idea what I just got. This is a fairly fun drop here. You kind of want to aim for this corner of the room here. And down there is, I don't exactly know what it's technical name is, but it's like a super werewolf, for lack of a better term. And it didn't attack me the first time I played here, and it doesn't respawn. So I'm not really sure what the deal is with it. So he didn't attack me the first time, so I don't really know what. I guess I fell in a different way or something where he didn't notice me or something. Either way, he doesn't respawn. I'm not sure what the significance of him actually is. So here we are on the lower streets or something. Get real specific with you guys.
A night to remember, wouldn't you say, friend?
I think we're in the lower cathedral ward or something.
A night occurred, wouldn't you say?
But this area has the Sack Bros. They hit extremely hard. Almost one-shotting you hard. It's nuts how strong they are. And at this point, I do not want to get killed by them, because if you get killed by one, at this point, you go to jail. You don't wake up in the dream, they kidnap you. Don't want to get kidnapped yet. damage on this saw cleaver when it is closed is terrible. That's one of them right there. They can kick you, they can punch you, and they have a really long range. And then they have this buff that they apply to themselves at about half health. And they have a sack smack, where they will overhand slam their sack of body parts or whatever. And the sack slam will absolutely wreck you. Like, it one-shotted me on my first playthrough one time. Okay. So, does this look familiar? Other side of the fence where you picked up a shield. Ready to go back into the cathedral yet. There's one more gate to unlock. And when you're ready to fight Amelia, there's going to be a summon sign right here. And when you ring it, you're going to get your first evil bell, which means that it opens up your world to being invaded. It says off in the distance. A sinister bell rings, but it's right up here. As we climb this ladder, there will be one of the sinister bell ringing ladies will be standing right here. If you kill her, then it basically closes your world off to invaders. Okay, so there's two routes you can go. There's another gate over here we need to unlock. There's regular pimps, and then there's a couple of huge pimps over here, so... You know. Oh, and dogs. There's some dogs around the corner. So you can hear the... big pimps. Thank you. to, so this is why there's two ways you can go. Going this way is easier. There's a pack of beasts to deal with, but basically all the pimps are kind of like waiting for you at the stairs. Oh wait, the beasts are in the DLC version of this area. My bad. If you go this way, you can kind of get the jump on these guys. These guys are a little bit different. If he can actually hit me from up here. That was a little hat. I would give anything for a way to make the item pickup prompt go away after a certain period of time. That's been a complaint of mine since Demon Souls. Okay. Obviously, these guys are kind of optional. Kinda keep them separated. Yeah, keep them separated. You guys, but I'm ready for some twin shard action so I can get this thing juiced up. Yeah. lots of Madman's knowledge around this area. I'm not really sure what the significance of it is, though. But at this point, once we, I believe, exit and then come back in into this area, Crow Hunter Aline is going to be waiting down there for us. So we can continue her quest line as long as we don't kill Amelia or Rom. I think if you kill either of those, then it kind of breaks the quest line. Here takes us all the way back around to where that first big pimp is hanging out. So back around there's the entrance to the Cathedral Ward. I think this is the one that you could open up if you bought the handkerchief for 10 grand. It's a huge ripoff. So you're gonna have to go through. You're gonna have to go through all this area. More or less, anyways, so. Poison knives. Those are really handy for if you're gonna fight Henrik, which I highly recommend you do to progress with Crow Hunter Aline. Then you can hit him with some poison knives to kind of help tilt the fight in your favor and make sure that Aline doesn't die.
Oh, the stench of blood and beasts any day. What is it then? I'm off. During hunt wouldn't want to drag you.
So she is.
Oh, how good might you know of a safe club the night is. Please. Oh, thank you. Perhaps I'll.
She is the prostitute that has a very interesting end game turn of events.
You! Well, an outsider who's come to join you, you what? What, you think I'm a beast? And step away from my... What, you think this is... Well, I certainly don't. I'll have nothing to do.
I think this is the guy that...
Well, what's this? I heard you told that way. Well, she's a damn fool. No way.
I can't remember which one of the guys. I think this might be the guy that...
All right. You think I'm an easy mark?
I'm not gonna tell
you. What, afraid you like? Yeah, I knew you'd back. You're an outsider.
Yeah, sure. So, once you go back and talk to fake Yosefka, she'll tell you to send people to her clinic.
This is a damn bug.
That guy goes to the opposite place that you tell him to go. Yeah,
Praise you, and then the best of luck, guys.
The Church Hunter set is... That's what you need before you get kidnapped. You put that on, then you can send the girl who's in jail. And send her to the chapel. Cleared this place out. So we're basically just on the other side of the big staircase. That's talking about Logarius. Or not, he's got the wheel. I don't know if it's Alfred or not. But, yeah, so we're basically kind of on the other side of this big staircase that goes from that courtyard that we fought the two big pimps. It's all the way up to the cathedral where Amelia is located. This is where you'll meet up with him, and he has I guess a password or something, or you show him the Canehurst invitation. Okay, so yeah, so off in the distance that is the Forbidden Woods out there. and we've got the lighthouses, and then way off in the distance is Caner's castle, I believe. So we'll actually go up inside those windmills. So again, really cool being able to see what you can eventually get to. And you know, my first time playing through this, I really had no idea how interconnected everything was. So being able to see it now, I have kind of like a new appreciation for it. But get on these stairs, and there's a door that we don't have a password to just yet. Or actually for quite a while.
The pass.
Rather tricky area all the way up the steps and to the right of Amelia's boss fight area. There are two NPC hunters. Okay, yeah, see there, we got the summon sign for the guy. I bet we could take him down there. I bet we could take him down there and wreck him up. But one of the guys has a Tenitrus, which is pretty nasty. Yeah, let's do that. Also worth mentioning, there are these guys with these big, not quite crucifixes. They hit really hard. Amelia's boss area up there, and we're not going to go up there yet because we've got business with Alina to take care of, but I'm going to here, and then there's that guy with the electrified mace, the Tenitrus. Put your daggum torch away, Henriette. Good. Serious? wasted ammo. Stuck. Let's do this. Really? Okay. Bring the fight to you then. What? screw these guys when they're infinite ammo. About a silencing blank that girl.
Bless us, bless us.
Blessed by the blood.
Bless us with blood.
So there's a sack bro up there that I'm not gonna mess with. And then there is a couple of the big ogre guys. Through this cave and a few of the see if I can hear him walking. And these are the much stronger executioner guys. And be one thing to just run down there and fight them, but you've got some snipers up there, and if you go back up the other way and kill the sack bro, you can drop down, kill those guys first, and then have a much easier time taking those guys out. So I've got way too many souls to cash in, and I need to continue on with Alien's quest. Continue with Alien's quest line, and I'm also going to get Hendrix swag. There's some really strong stuff for physical and lightning, which I will definitely need fighting Coral. Head back to Dream. She's useless. I guess she's really not really, or really, I guess, scripted to go to the cathedral, and that's pretty much it. If you go this way. Area. Fog gate's down there because Henriette is still in my game. So I can only lift up. Let's see where the silencing blink. Could have used a bold hunter's mark. I don't want to use that since that's infinite. You'll restart when I tell you to. Just kidding, it's Windows 10 again. It's gonna restart whenever it wants to. Oh, there she is.
Oh, hello there. Perfect timing. Not to go near the tomb below Erden Chapel in the Cathedral Ward. Henrik, an old hunter. has gone mad. And he's my mark. Don't go near the tomb. I have business.
It's an awesome set. Anything else to say?
Ah, the hat, thank you. Well, she don't offer me much in the way of conversation, but still, I'd rather see her alive anyhow. If you find any, send them along to her. I guess she doesn't say anything different until we kill Amelia. I guess he fake Eos has to go.
Oh, what splendid. You're soon off to hunt, then. You tell them to seek Yosef. Upon my Hippocratic oath, this sickness, this time the night is long. I may be trapped here, but I should do something to help. I'll even offer a reward for your cooperation. Tempted?
Well, she got a gun.
Well, off you go then. If you find any, you can assure, please.
So we can go tell the we can go tell the guy down across the street from the prostitute woman. We can tell him. We can tell him to go to the clinic. And he'll actually go to the chapel. It really doesn't give you a whole lot. Let's see what we can buy first. Beside Ludwig's blade. Nothing besides fire paper. Yeah. So, you know, we can take anything we want up to +3, which whoop-de-doo, but. The real gem in all this is Ludwig's blade, but I used that a lot in the first time through. It was that and the axe, which I kind of lean a little bit more towards the axe. But once I got the whirly gig, it was over. That thing is just it's just savage. So, anyways.
Welcome. Very well.
I get two of them. And then a second one. Two out of both those, I get 30. And 22. I can't count, it's too late, my brain isn't working. I'm just gonna do one of these. Okay. No. And the next video, let's see what's next. Henrik and maybe Parl. Parl's gonna be pretty rough at this point in the game, I believe. So I might actually do one. I think I have to get captured too. I think I'm gonna do some of the Henrik stuff, unless I, I'll tell you what, I'm just gonna take a stab at Amelia so that I can make a run at the Whirly Gig in the DLC, and if I make that, then it's gonna be on for the rest of the game. That'll be fun running through the whole game with the Whirly Gig. So anyways, thanks for watching. Until next time, good day.